Pretty much right here we have the M240 Bravo with our Iron Man backpack, and we have our an adapter for the 240 Bravo. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put it together. Just pop that pin in, and you have to push in on both sides. And then this pin over here locks it right into place. Then you take your 240 Iron Man backpack, go ahead and take the feed chute, shift it around, and then as you can see, the two clamps slide inside. You open up the gator clips and it clips right in there. Now, this idea came from a soldier wanting to have mass firepower on the objective. So they came to us with an idea of how they could carry much more 7.62 without using an ammo bear. So they came to the engineers, talked to the engineers. The engineers developed this backpack and applying the feed chute to it, and you can carry 500 rounds. As you can see, once you put the backpack on, soldier assisted, and it snaps right into place. Ideally, we say that we want you to have the feed chute coming over the shoulder and not under the shoulder. It prevents more twists, and it doesn't have the stoppage of ammo as it's feeding through the gun. And there you go. Pretty much you can fire it at this point in time in any position. You can fire it in the standing, you can fire it in the kneeling, and fire it in the prone. It has been tested. ATEC has tested it, and we're continuing to test it with other weapon systems. The other weapon system in which we've tested this weapon with is the Mark 48. These pins don't slide out very easily. And that's your detached part. So you take it away from the 240 Bravo, and soldiers came to us with another idea of utilizing the Iron Man backpack with the Mark 48. So what we did, we came up with another engineering design. All right, soldiers came to us with an idea saying they want to use the Iron Man backpack with the Mark 48. So we basically took the 240 Bravo adapter that already comes with the weapon system, and we made a prototype of this, which is our Mark 48 adapter, which slides into the 240 adapter. And with the locking pin, you lock that into position. Now you just take the 240 adapter and you slide it into the position for the Mark 48. And as you can see, it locks in on the right side of the gun and it locks in on the left side of the gun. Now you just take the gator clips, remove the gator clips, and attach it onto the Mark 48 adapter. Now you have the same functionality of that you have with the 240 with the Mark 48.
sing it, thing you teeth open.
Oh, that would be nice.
That's nice.
Jesus. What do you think? I thought it was cheese. I got this big bite of clutter in my mouth.
But, what's going to be the
background music? Official background music? 18th theme? 18th theme, maybe?
All right, so what we have here is it's a compact, high-speed CNC machine. And by high-speed, I actually mean high RPMs, not fancy, although it's pretty fancy. What you do is you load a stock piece of metal. In this case, it's a big chunk of aluminum. And this machine follows a computer-generated tool path to remove material until what's left behind is the exact part you want. What we received was a request from an RCP group to improve the stowage of their metal detecting assets while they're on mission, specifically in the RG-31 vehicle. And so what we did is we designed a modular holder that mounts on the walls of the RG-31 and allows them to securely stow their metal detectors.
We can meet that capability gap for that soldier, allowing him to walk out of here with an item in which he may take on a mission gives me and my team a great sense of responsibility, a great sense of accomplishment that we have just took the next step in an innovative process for Afghanistan and the warfighter out here in Afghanistan. So we look forward to any time a soldier comes in to see us, and then that overall expectation when he walks out the door, we know that he is more mission capable in completing his mission. As the RAF, as the Rapid Equipping Force, we're the Army's Title 10 response in equipping, being innovative, and producing items for Afghanistan in a rapid way. So instead of going through the long-term process of waiting 1-2 years to equip something, the Rapid Equipping Force is the response and the answer for getting things in soldiers' hands and into theater very quickly.
Thank you.
that's the only change to take away.
Pretty much right here we have the M240 Bravo with our Iron Man backpack, and we have our an adapter for the 240 Bravo. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put it together. Just pop that pin in, and you have to push in on both sides. And then this pin over here locks it right into place. Then you take your 240 Iron Man backpack, go ahead and take the feed chute, shift it around. And then as you can see, the two clamps slide inside. You open up the gator clips and it clips right in there. Now, this idea came from a soldier wanting to have mass firepower on the objective. So they came to us with an idea of how they could carry much more 7.62 without using an ammo bear. So they came to the engineers, talked to the engineers. The engineers developed this backpack and applying the feed chute to it, and you can carry 500 rounds. As you can see, once you put the backpack on. Soldier assistant. And it snaps right into place. Ideally, we say that we want you to have the feed chute coming over the shoulder and not under the shoulder. It prevents more twists, and it doesn't have the stoppage of ammo as it's feeding through the gun. And there you go. Pretty much you can fire it at this point in time in any position. You can fire it in the standing, you can fire it in the kneeling, and fire it in the prone. It has been tested. ATEC has tested it, and we're continuing to test it with other weapon systems. The other weapon system in which we've tested this weapon with is the Mark 48. These pins don't slide out very easily. And that's your detached part. So you take it away from the 240 Bravo, and soldiers came to us with another idea of utilizing the Iron Man backpack with the Mark 48. So what we did, we came up with another engineering design. All right, soldiers came to us with an idea saying they want to use the Iron Man backpack with the Mark 48. So we basically took the 240 Bravo adapter that already comes with the weapon system, and we made a prototype of this, which is our Mark 48 adapter, which slides into the 240 adapter. And with the locking pin, you lock that into position. Now you just take the 240 adapter and you slide it into the position for the Mark 48. And as you can see, it locks in on the right side of the gun and it locks in on the left side of the gun. Now you just take the gator clips, remove the gator clips and attach it onto the Mark 48 adapter. Now you have the same functionality of that you have with the 240 with the Mark 48.